Welcome back to my channel. This is your boy Ja, coming to you from Kingston, Jamaica, right? Woo! Guys, I swear I would just fall asleep right here. It's so peaceful in the park. So relaxing, trust me. The breeze, the scenery, every single thing is just perfect. So today's review is just gonna be on a house I've recently dived into deeply, and it is none other than Roja Dove, alright? I believe last year, I've been trying some fragrances over the years. However, last year, while I was in New York, I believe I visited Saks Fifth Avenue, where I smelled quite a few from the house. And my initial thoughts on the house was that it was overpriced. That's all. I guess that was a premature assumption. I should have explored the house more before I really made my judgment, in which that's what I did recently. I tried quite a few from the house, and I must tell you guys, they are phenomenal. So in order to not make this video pretty long, I'm just gonna dive straight into my review, all right? Don't go anywhere. So in doing this review, guys, I'm just gonna tell you straight up, I won't be diving into notes much in its entirety. I'll just be telling you guys, hold on, my apologies. I won't be diving into notes, guys. I'll be telling you guys my experience with these fragrances, such as performance, projection, longevity, and compliment factor as well, all right? So without further ado, let me get straight into it. The first one I'll be talking about is Quatar. This one is a beautiful leather-based fragrance, I'm telling you. I wore this one sometime last week to work. I believe I only received one compliment from this one. The performance on this one, easily over 8 hours. The projection, I can't really speak definitively in terms of how long the projection was for, but I can tell you guys, even after the 8 hour mark, I was still getting whiffs of this one. The sillage overall, beautiful, guys. I left from my desk, and as soon as I came back, like a couple seconds later, the scent trail was right there. The bathroom was the same thing, guys. Beautiful leather base. There are some sweetness in this one as well. I believe there are some spices as well. This is well composed, and it is Quatar. The next one I'll be talking about. No, I'll save this one. No, all right, let me talk about this one. This is Sweetie Oud. The name itself, let me tell you straight up, the name itself is misleading, all right? Reason being is that when I first tried this fragrance, I wasn't expecting the whiff or the scent that I was getting from this one. This is not like a candied sweetness. This is more of a gourmand quality oud-based fragrance, all right? This one, when I first applied this fragrance, the initial blast I got was of a pastry shop, a freshly baked cookie. I wasn't getting any candied sweetness, in which that's what I was hoping for. But the caramelized pastry I was getting, freshly baked, was enough to sold me on this one. To add to this fragrance, which is Sweetie Oud, the compliment factor on this one, I got 4 solid compliments that day. 4 solid compliments, one of which, there was a manager at my job. I was around by a T-section, and he came in behind someone, and he was looking around, puzzled, wondering, or he was about to ask her what she was wearing, when suddenly he turned around and saw me and said, "You were the one I was smelling." So he loved this one. Even this week, I believe he messaged me about this one as well. So Sweetie Oud, this projection on this one, phenomenal longevity. It's still in the shirt that I wore about 2 weeks ago. The scent trail, guys, easily over 10 feet. Because one of my compliments came from about 10 feet or more, guys. So I will be looking at partial of this one or a full bottle. However, I don't think I can afford a full bottle at the time, so I'll be looking at partial of this one. Next, the next one I'll be talking about is Noah. I hope I pronounced it correctly. This is one of the most beautiful rose-based fragrance I have ever smelled, this one. It is sexy, it is sophisticated, everything about this one is perfect. Performance, easily beyond 10 hours. Projection, I got a good projection on this one. Compliment factor, I think I got around 1 or 2 compliments on this one. I like it, yeah I do. I don't love it that much, but this is really, really nice. The other one I'll be talking to you guys about is Parfum de la Nuit 2. This one retails for about $1,400 and something US. I managed to get a partial from Cesar. Cesar, let me give you a shout out right now. Thank you, bro, for hooking me up. I think I will definitely be going for another 5 ml or 2 out of 5 ml of this one. This compliment factors on this one, I got 5 solid compliments. I love this one. This and Sweetie Oud are my 2 favorite from the recent discovery. Creation E Parfum Cologne is my ultimate favorite from the house. But this one, beautiful. The performance, easily beyond 12 hours. Projection, easily beyond 10 hours. Longevity, performance, everything on this one is on point, guys. I really, really did enjoy this one. And I can still be looking at partial because it will be pretty expensive for the partial. But I am definitely looking to add about 2 more 5 ml of this one. Thanks again, Cesar. And the last one I'll be telling you guys about is Parfum de la Nuit 3. And this is the big brother for the 2. I don't like this one as much as I love the 2. But the compliment factor on this one, I believe I got 0. I don't think... Ooh. Yeah, I did. I got 1 compliment. My apologies. 1 compliment. The performance on this one, I wasn't sold on performance. However, I recently did laundry, and let me tell you guys, I was folding the clothes, and let me tell you straight, I cannot believe I was still getting whiffs of this fragrance in the shirt I wore it in. Performance, I was getting whiff after the 10-hour mark. Projection, I believe it was still projecting. Longevity, everything on this one is just beautiful. It's just the compliment factors. I did not get much compliment. So on that basis, I prefer 2 over this one. So there you have it. That was just my quick take on these 5 fragrances that I recently discovered from the house of Roja Dove. I will be bringing you guys a review on the Parfum Cologne, the ultimate, the entire collection itself, pretty soon. So guys, stay tuned for that one. And this is your boy Jack coming to you from the beautiful park in Kingston, Jamaica. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and leave a comment down below, all right? Peace, I'm out.